Like I said earlier on, there are three top pieces. No, one, two, three. It is three or equal, and there are prizes. I did this last night, and I encouraged it. If I do that, please make some noise. I'm like Tinkerbell. If you don't make a noise, I'm going to die. Come on. There are prizes. You're learning. You're learning. I like this when they learn. The prizes tonight, we have a prize for the artist and the client. The prizes, again, these are fantastic pieces of work. We've got hand-painted skate decks by Nipper Tattoo, which, if you don't keep them, I'm stealing, because I am a kleptomaniac. For the client, the prizes are, we have a hand-painted original piece, banknote by Lal Hardy, and a pair of VIP weekend tickets for our next show, because we're so sick of the pandemic. No! There's only so much we can do, but we're going to do our best to make sure that for our 14th year next year, it's going to be banging. Oh, I'm sorry. The voices from above are saying, actually, there's more prizes. Wow. Okay, let me double check. Yep, there's a caravan. And a speedboat. I don't know about you, but I'm excited. Oh, and some, and BFH. What's BFH? Bus fare home. Thank you. I thought I was really old, and then I realised you're all fucking children. Anyway, that other prize that we have for the tattooist, it's also very, very important because it's a year's supply of gloves. And we all know everything has got more expensive, so we're happy to offer these prizes to the artists. And the, I like it when people try to hunch over and not be up to... Babe, you can, if you're going to walk, do it with your head held high. Stride of pride, I like to call it. Especially when I'm coming out of some random tip shop. Tip shop! Trying to catch myself here. Tips, hey. Don't have chips till you're older. Oh, come on. It's as good as I'm going to get for a legal minute. Right, well, ready when you are, because I can just talk for hours. Oh, well, thanks for paying me. You ready? All right. Okay, there are quite a few people, so I'm going to talk very loudly, and I'm going to bring to the stage the first piece. We have the contestant is Sophie Aylin, if you want to come on, Sophie. And please clap. This is a piece by the team, amongst his own emporium in Tanstruck, Devon. And this is a back piece and a very fetching little butterfly bra. Those things are useless on me, it just makes my boobs like fold in half. Well, it's not that sort of show. Cover the eyes and the ears, like, honestly, these poor children. Honestly, if I don't wear a bra, it's like running with dog ears. Not good in this window, I'll tell you that. I'm not a Springer Spaniel. I'm more a chicken roll. Thank you, my lovely. She's half naked in a bunch of strange people. And she's not even getting paid. Thank you, sweetheart. Next up, we've got Jake Horwood, the contestant who's been tattooed by Kelsey Whitfield. Whitfield tattoos in Barnstable. This is a thigh piece. That's on the left thigh, I think. Yes, I'm getting good at anatomy. Well, definitely my own, because it's been a lonely lockdown. I don't know about you, but I've learned new things about myself. I'm actually a fan of hummus. Never thought I'd be in hummus. I'm like, I might be 40, but why do I all of a sudden have to become that stereotypical queer that's into hummus and green tea? I got angry at my local coffee place because they've got tropical green tea. What is this? Blah, my ginseng. Yeah, I'm not allowed in there anymore. Ridiculous. Thank you so much for that. Next up, Kate McLeod, if you want to come onto the stage, my lovely. This is a piece by Colin Whitfield. Oh, Whitfield Tattoo in Devon. Is it a family thing or? I don't want to make any inappropriate comments in case it is, because, you know, awkward. We don't talk about incest in London, it just happens. I'm really close to my brother. Sorry, kids. Maybe I was not the best choice for this show. I'm enjoying it. Don't have kids. Honestly, no, the best contraceptive, just wear a jumpsuit. You know when you're going for a piss and you have to take it off and sit there just in your bra? Best contraceptive ever. Yeah, right, Claire, me. media. Oh, cookie, you in a jumpsuit, dream. Nightmare, same fucking thing. Thank you so much. If you want to take a quick walk, I think people do want to see the piece, if you don't mind. Like I said, you can come closer in a non-creepy, consensual way. Because there are enough creepy bastards out there in Brighton anyway. Right, next up, I believe we have Emily H. You have to come on up, my darling. This is a piece done by someone called Cookie. That's my bed. Now, I love you really, Cookie. It's paying me for all of this. Apparently you've got a shop. I haven't really, Cookie. Inkspot. Newcastle. Oh, no wonder. It's the only place they'd let you in, sweetheart. I've seen this piece a couple of times, and it looks... It's all right. Well done, mate. How long have you been doing it? Not bad. Not bad for an apprentice. Talking of the apprentice, I've actually applied to go onto The Apprentice. I don't know if it's a good idea or not, but I'm kind of tempted to go in drag and just see how they react. I think I'd scare the shit out of Alan Sugar. Well, also, if I go in when I'm dressed as a man, I most probably want to date me. I look good in every gender. It's too true. Ha ha! Right. On Instagram, and I was like, oh my god, look at this. Not only are they stunning artists, but she's pretty fit. I apologise. I've consensual elements of my show. I tried to be polite, and the nicest compliment I could think of was pretty fit. I'm obviously going down the dating route of a 19-year-old called Kyle. Are there any 19-year-olds called Kyle in the room? Because if so, give me some more dating advice, because at the minute, I don't know what you do. I've kind of gone up to someone and like flashed. Apparently that's inappropriate behaviour on a bus. I was like, makes National Express a lot more fun when you're there for 3 hours. Yeah, that's wonderful. If you want to go and take a look around the front to show it off. Well, that would be lovely. Thank you so much. Again, all of the pieces that are worked on have been finished or started and then finalised whilst they've been here this weekend. That was number 6.
What's your name?
Ah, it's Kyle. My apologies. I was too excited talking about buses. It happened. Yeah. Okay. So now I'm going to go back to the correct order of the list. Look, I'm pretty. What more do you want? Well, I like to think I'm pretty. At number 5, David Sharp. Now this one is Anthony Lennox, Atrium Inc. in Exeter. And I have to say, these boxer shorts are rather fetching. I don't know if people actually think about when they're coming on stage what they're wearing in their pants region. You know, it's like today I'm feeling that it's actually pink flamingo, so he's feeling a bit camp and a bit lively. I'm going to have to say, have you got a flamingo in your pants, are you? Just please just see me. Sweetheart, I can't help it if he's got 3 legs. But hey! Camp. Oh, come on, Cookie. Look, at the end of the day, I'm doing this and you're doing that. All right, sweetheart. All right, love. I've just come by your shop and telling you shit for free. I am available for... you know, humiliation sessions in your business. I'm always welcome to come. I do it in Lidl all the time. Waitrose, I love complaining posh in Waitrose because they just look at me and then I can put on an accent and they look like, oh Lord, one of us. I'm like, oh goodness, I'm sorry, but this pâté, it's so out of season. Fucking hilarious. Weirdos and creeps weren't in Brighton. But you can have my OnlyFans though, that's at Smashing on Her. See, that was censored. chairman of the New York team. Next up, we've got number 7. This is Manny Harris, if I'm correct. And I can read. Check this shit out. Manny has been tattooed at Noiring, London, by Chris Hirawaka. If I've got that wrong, I apologise, because this handwriting is too neat and I don't know what the fuck's going on. This is a piece on the right arm, so that's this. Do you know biology? It's this thing here. I should be a doctor. I'm amazing. I'm really good at finding things like the hidden clitoris. I'm glad you got that. I said that one night, and someone was like, what's a clitoris? I was like, sweetheart, should I meet your wife? If she's still with you. I was like, yeah, yeah, 15 years. And I was like, and you've still not found the clitoris? Don't worry, Cookie, I'm here for all marriage advice you need, sweetheart. Although I've been engaged 3 times and never quite got to the church. I think I'd set on fire if I walked into one. Wonderful. Thank you so much, my darling. If you want to take a walk around, you can show it up or you can fuck off. Your choice. Right. Next up, we've got number 8, if I'm correct. That is Deepesh Chopra. Nepal, Kathmandu. Again, it's not that sort of show. You can tell where it is. I mean, I'm more than happy to help you later, but again, it's at Smashlin Monroe. Only fans, yeah. Again, I mean, the detail is phenomenal. Open your eyes. I will see what I can do, but we do have to get through them quite quickly. So, sorry, it's not a family party. I can't do requests like the YMCA or Macho Macho Man. Always Superman. If you're old, you'll remember the Superman. What was that one word? Sick of 2023. And again, an amazing quiz. Thank you so much for being fabulous and showing this off. If you want to walk delicately away. Call me. Okay. It's 07909. Next up, before I get told off, give me out my real phone number. I'm lonely, alright. Next up, we've got number 9, Will Tunnicliffe. Is that right? Or am I just shouting names for the fun of it? Will, come on, Will. Will here has been tattooed by John Williams at Noir Inc. in London. We love a good danger act up on a chair, no insurance. Woohoo! I do this, but I'm shit because I broke my ankle last year. I know, I'm bionic. It's supposed to make you faster. I'm like, no, it made me fatter. Not dyslexic, you bastards. Fatter, faster! That's what Cookie said as well. Mate, honestly, the stories I could tell about him. I'm not gonna, because again, I'm really worried about your children. I'm sorry. You bought them, it's your own fault, really, but.
There are 12 swear words he's counting.
What, that I've said?
Yeah.
Oh, come, fuck, no, shit. Fudge. Fudge. I'll try to think of less. Actually, all I know is swear words. Like, if I hit 100, I'm sorry. I'm gonna count. If I hit 100, you'll get a fiver. Off your dad, because not me. I ain't your dad. Well, there's been a few weekends in Brighton before. You never quite know, do you? Next up, if I'm correct, number 10, Martina. Oh, look at this reading shit. I'm getting really good. This is a piece by Dagmar Galecka at Black Anchor Tattoo in Nottingham. I do know Nottingham. I grew up near there, but I left for a reason. Do you want to know the reason? Childhood trauma. Thank you. Give me a whoop if you've got childhood trauma. I love this. I feel appreciated with my own kind. You know, there is a Samaritan's number if you need it. It's also underneath my number. Thank you so much, my darling. Next up, number 11. Is it Rachel? Oh. Oh, reading what's on the form. I'm only reading what they give me. Yeah. So it's still number 11, but different contestant name. I apologise. Yeah, just, I'm only here to talk shit and look pretty. It's not my fault if I get given cruddy information. Are you single? Dang, I'm fine with that if you are. I like sharing, just not food. So come over for chili sometime. Yeah, so always works with the ladies. It actually doesn't work with the ladies. It doesn't work with anyone unless they're fetish fat feeders, because they love me. Thank you so much, Sophia. Again, a beautiful back piece. Okay, number 12. Is it Callum? Come on up then, please, Callum. Crew, you've been tattooed Luke Ashley at Aura 94 in London. And this is looking like it's a palm piece, or is pretending he's Jesus, you know. Whatever floats your boat, we all like a bit of cosplay. Personally, never done a Jesus, but I've done a Pope. That was really awkward. Apparently, Christian weddings don't like it if you turn up dressed as a Pope. I never knew that. I was encouraged to dress up in what made me feel good. And it was dressing up as Pope John Paul III. I look good in robes. Oh, honey, I look good in anything. Body bag, carrier bag, bin bag, your handbag. So do keep an eye on your stuff, because if I see it, I will take it. I spent a lot of time in Croydon in my youth, so, you know. Hobbies. Not that I'm going to offend anyone, because Croydon is a lovely place. Oh, can you smell that? Bull poo. That's a tea, bull poo. Oh, now the kids are leaving, bullshit. Thank you so much. If you want to show it off, you can do in Jesus pose. Right, next up. Is it Alex? Wicked. Alex Lloyd has been tattooed by Tyler Hill from Pardon My French and Camberwell. I wondered what he was doing with his trousers then. I'm like, I think I've seen you before. Actually, if he turns round, I recognise him. Forgot that my laugh is horrendous on a microphone. People are going to have nightmares about that cackle now. All I need is two witches and a cauldron and we're good to go. Right in the armpit. I mean, what? Why? I don't even like shaving the armpit, but maybe it's a kink. Who knows? No kink shaming here. Got very manly nipples. Because, you know, nipples on a man are fine, but a woman, no. What are you doing with your trousers every time you look at me? It's like, sweetheart. I'll take you home and ride you till you die. Hey. Did I say that out loud? That was not my inside voice, was it? Anyway, thanks very much. Next up, again, hoping I can count number 14. We've got Dan Scott. No. Number 15, Aaron Lovelock. Hey! Verity Fox has been tattooing you, apparently. And Skull, Dam, and Dagger. Ooh, from. I couldn't read what it said. I thought it said from. I was like, no, where are you from? From. That's over there somewhere in the southerly part of the country. Yes, please, if you do know your number, that's good to be in an order because again, it's like reading from a bingo card. So if I'm right, he's just said that these pieces have been done over 2 days? Or he's trying to block me out, which most people do. I do have that sort of voice where it's like, grating, you might say, Richard. Grating. We've got number 18 now. Who's just shouting? It's not bingo. Can you stop just shouting random numbers at me? Else? Are we going straight to number 18? Is it Laura? Yay, Laura! If you'd like to come on stage, please, Laura. Your artist is Abigail Louise and Tom Boy. And they are based in Bournemouth. See, we're getting the names right. It's not my fault if they come on in the wrong order. Or if they're confused again, Numbers are hard. I'm really bad at counting. Apart from all the engagement rings and the shoes, I've got a fuck ton. That's a correct measurement, isn't it? Fuck ton. He's like, Dad, can't wait to get that fiver. Don't forget, it's going to your counselling fund. And this looks like the same artist has done my majority of this work. It's very lovely. And again, coming up and presenting in something like this is never easy. But when it's our work, I think we can all be very appreciative, can't we? So if we can do a round of applause. It is a family show, so I'm trying my best. I don't think I could do any better, but I'm trying to stay away from the hard words. Yeah, if you want to go that way, my lovely. Yeah, mind the wires, health and safety. You had 24 hours to get gaffer tape. 24 hours. I don't know, I can't work under these circumstances, but I will. Because I understand I'm hard work too. You know, backstage, I don't ask for anything unusual in my rider. Maybe a can of Coke and a signed picture of Doc Cotton from EastEnders. What's wrong with that? I think that's a perfectly good rider. Pat Butcher. Next year, I want Pat Butcher. Can you make a note of that? Brilliant. Okie doke. So if I'm correct, again, Alex? Woo! Alex, if you want to come up, please. Alex has been tattooed by Samsara. Samsara Tattoos in Bournemouth. Yeah, where'd you go with that? I can't answer because there's kids in the room, Woody. That's not fair, mate. Again, artists is continually. Is this been done over years? Is the whole piece? Because it all looks. Yeah, it looks like they've done the majority of the middle here this weekend. I'm like, my attention span is too short. I'd start tattooing and then end up just writing, cut! It's not good for my Tourette's, honestly. There's another pound for it. Good job I didn't say a pound of swear word. You would be going to Hawaii.
Hello.
Thanks, Dad. Well, with this being the 13th year, I don't know about you, but I'm really glad that this convention actually happened. Because the last 2 years, a lot of the stuff I love has been cancelled. So thank you all so much for being here. We know Storm Munis didn't help. But honestly, we're glad that you're here. And these pieces are fantastic. I'm regretting a lot of my shit tattoos now, but it's too late. You know, some people are born with gorgeous tattoos, and then there's just me. Thanks, Cookie. Yeah! Wonderful. Well, now you're giving us a dodgy table and no gaffer tape. Mate, we're going to have a word about Richard. Yeah, I tell you that from backstage. I was like, seriously, is there a HR department I can complain to? Turn around and he's there. Anyway, I'm going to double check with the beardy fella because he's giving me thumbs up or words. I'm sure you have a name, but today you are Beardy Man. It's the politest thing I could think of. I'm much better at giving people like offensive nicknames. So I'm gonna stop. Cause I don't know, see, look at the finger. I'm having flashbacks to me, Dad, will you stop doing that? Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Is that close enough? Not better. Did you get a selfie? There you go. I am much better from far away, I promise you. Normally with bars, for your own safety, because this animal does bite. That's clear on my YouTube channel. I don't have a YouTube channel, they won't let me, I keep getting banned. All I was doing was eating food, making ASMR, which is fun, but also I'm fat, so I like food. Combining the two, and apparently one of my videos got banned because it needs to be censored. I can't help if it was good chicken. Next up, again, I'm looking at the list. Is it John? Wait, come on, John Luby, if you can come on the stage, my darling. 18 is, oh. Yeah, that's, sorry, I was waiting for Beardy Man's confirmation. Yeah, Beardy Man. Yeah, well, what's your name? I can't hear you. Nigel.
Roger.
Oh, I'd stick with Nigel if I were you, babe. It's not much better. Oh, no! Ah, oh, Roger, the cabin boy! Captain Pumwash, right? Okay, maybe I'm giving him childhood trauma flashbacks. I don't know how many cabins you've seen. So yes, this is John, tattooed by Jordan Croke at Sangria Tattoo in Derby. Derby's a nice place when you're leaving. Looks lovely. That's excellent. Thank you so much for showing, my lovely. I think what we're doing now is when you, contestants, when you're coming off and you're about to leave, this lovely lady's asking to take pictures. So if you can remember, because I didn't realise, I thought she was just taking pictures of me. Apparently it's not, which I think is rude. Am I photobombing every shot? Okay, so we're going to number 20 now. Sophie Craig, if you could come up, my darling. I believe you've been tattooed by Amy Billing at Hobo Jack Tattoo in Bournemouth. Beautiful Bournemouth, God's waiting room. But I've also heard that there are a lot of young people. Honestly. I like Bournemouth, I go there and feel young. House, 24, what? Please tell, Roger, don't confuse me. It's easily done, like, if you give me a packet of crisps, I'll always open it the wrong way round, mate. Or I'll just eat the bag, I get really hungry. I stress eat. And talk, can you tell? That's beautiful. Thank you so much. Where's the photo? No. Yeah, photo lady. I really should learn the names of people. Roger Beardy Man and photo lady. This should go on your CV with your many skills. Next up, if we're going by chronological order, at 21. Woo! Please welcome to stage Liz Buxton. Being tattooed by Jesse Madgrove at Skull Dagger in Frome. I can read Frome now. Doing well. I like what you've done with the t-shirt, it's very modern. And you know, a little revealing is not a bad thing. I think it gives you confidence in yourself and you love the styling. Maybe a bit of eyeliner next time, but you look gorge. We can't all be fabulous. Oh, don't look at my face, that's why I put so much fucking makeup on. To cover up my creases and crinkles. I think that was about number 24, wasn't it? The sweat, he's like, yep. Yeah. Give that kid nightmares, I swear. It's not just kids that I scare, it's human beings. This is why I've been single for 7 years. Out of choice, because she got put in prison. But it wasn't my fault. I wasn't there at the time. Well, I was just very well hidden. Like a museum of boobs, just stood there. Thank you so much for that. Yeah, get a bit of lighting. As you can see, it's a beautiful bag piece. I think that's beautiful. I'm sure you sat like a dream. Did you? You tried to. Okay, did you fart any time? I'm like, honestly, if someone's got their arse out and you don't fart, are you even a tattoo artist anymore? No. Thank you so much for coming up. Okay, are we going to number 22? Look at that, Roger, we're getting good at this, mate. The dream team. Number 22, I've got Claire Louise Solby. If I could get you up on the stage, this is tattooed by Joe Black at Black Moon Tattoo from Frome. I didn't realise Frome was that big a place to have more than one tattoo shop. How many people live there? Have you got electric? Gas? Internet? Brilliant. All the mod cons. Hopefully not Uber, I'm fucking sick of Uber, they get everywhere. And charge you the world. It's like having a Tory government. Oh, we do! Anyone vote Tory in the room? Just checking, because honestly, I'm up for some Smackdown tonight. I'll be out by the bins if there's any Tories that want to sort it out and have a fight. Again, I'm lonely. I'm trying to approach to anyone that will have a fight with me. Thank you so much for that, my lovely. Oh, it's all right. I'm just literally like, you're gonna find these pictures and be like, who the hell is that in the background? I know, people confuse me with Mariah Carey all the time. Well, Mariah Carey when she's having a fat day. Or I look like I've eaten Mariah Carey. Anyway, next up, if I'm correct, we're gonna have Luke Ward. Woo, if you can come onto the stage, please, Luke. You've been tattooed by Aaron Kingsley at Black Harpy Tattoo, Kent. Kent is famous for something, but I'm not quite sure what. Did the royal family have a home there? Wouldn't surprise me, they've got them everywhere. Or is that where Andrew had to sell his? Sorry, mate. Oh, God. The people that like the royal family in the audience, again, maybe I should check before I start harping on about who's basically paying $12 million for him being a bit of a nonce.
Why not? Don't be a hater.
It's just an opinion, but when it's in the media, it's kind of out there. It's not my fault. I'm on Facebook too much. Lovely. Thank you so much for coming out. You can just wait whilst I take a picture. Know your number. Okay, number 24. If you'd like to come on stage, please. Jake, you've been tattooed by Joe Bird, High Flyer Tattoos in Newcastle. Again, your journey down here must have been a nightmare. It took me 7 hours just to get from London. I got kicked off 3 trains because I hadn't paid for a ticket, but that's not the point. If you ever traveled on anything out of London, why should I have to pay to sit somewhere that stinks of old men's sweat? You can get that for free here. Again, we have another chair balancing act. Honestly, I don't think I could get that high. It's probably better for the stage safety as well. Okay, so I'm going straight to 26. Thanks, Roger. That's me. There's no 25 on that one, judges. Oh, they're talking. That's rather good, isn't it? Yeah. Is it your first one? Portrait. Alright. Welcome to Tattoo. So have I, mate. Don't get all balls in me. See you by the bins. Alright then. I'll be done about 8:06. Alright. I can squeeze in a mate for 8:10 as well. Alright. I'm going to be really busy after the show. If I'm running after people, honestly. It's not my fault. I was born this way. And apparently God made me. Broke the mold on this one, didn't he, Big Dick, eh? Next up, I'm going to double check with Roger. Okay, no 25. Thank you. Because otherwise I'll get confused and end up calling you the wrong name, which we don't want. No, it's not professional. So we're going to go to number 26. Is it Shane Wise? If you want to come on, my lovely. Thank you very much. This piece has been done by Danny Green at the Keep Tattoo in Edinburgh. Again, I'm loving that they're all coming down south. But Newcastle and Edinburgh, north, right? Yeah. It's been done over the 2 days. So again, I don't think I could actually sit for 2 days in a row. I have the attention span of a goldfish or a panda. A trash panda, I think. I'm definitely more of a raccoon. Again, diving through bins. We all have to have hobbies. I think I'm funny anyway. You think I'm funny? Brilliant. I've got one friend. Roger's my mate now. Richard's my mate. All good. I'm not alone in this world, thank you. My apologies, I will say that out. Shane Wise, tattooed by Rich Harris, Dark Horse Collective, Sutton Coldfield. See, I'm not good at reading, but today. So, definitely in the right order, but I'm depending on you, Roger. You are like my lifeline to humanity. Like, I feel like we should go on a quest after this, mate. Shall we go find a ring? Lord of the Rings, come on, you know. I was trying to geek it out for you. One ring to rule them all, apparently, isn't it? No, just me, loving Tolkien. I haven't sworn in a while. Oh, doing well. Still talking crap. Fudge. Fudge off, you fudger. I'm just gonna start using that now. Okay, number 27. Matt Little, been tattooed by Little Nick at the church tattoo studio in Redditch. Again, another chair balancing act. Again, I'm hoping they've got insurance. I can barely stand on stage, let alone a chair. Redditch, is that Birmingham way? I'm really bad at knowing where places are in the country. Well, if I've never been there, I don't go, ooh, look at this place. I might go there. Apart from a place called Wetwang in Yorkshire. A real, you can Google it, Wetwang. I was a student, I was under the influence of something, and my mate just got in a car and we went to Wetwang. I was like, the people that live here, does that make them Wetwangers? Ha-ha! Apparently not. They didn't appreciate my sense of humour. Thank you so much, my darling. Got that one right. Number 28, Louise Noble. We will get you in 1 minute because we're still talking. Don't go anywhere, no, Louise, turn around. Look into my eyes. Look into my eyes. No, don't, because I'm creepy. I can't help it. How I have friends, I do not know. Because genuinely, I managed to creep people out. Hey, Richard. We do the same thing when we meet people. I find that licking your lips and rubbing your thighs, it's not a good thing. Oh, this next one, two artists. Damn, was it at the same time? Okay, that's very, very impressive. So this is a piece, we've got Kirsten Petit and Stephanie Melbourne at the Church Tattoo Studio in Redditch. I mean, like, that's gorgeous. I didn't realise you were getting a portrait of me, babe. Don't recognise you. Is that stalking ban still on? You've got to stay 50 metres away from me, right? Okay. I'll stand back. Again, seeing some of the artists, the work that is coming out from this convention is phenomenal. And it's one of those things I know just how bad the tattoo industry got hit by the pandemic. So it's great to see people back with a vengeance and really just create some beautiful things. I couldn't do it. Literally, I could barely paint my eyes, let alone anything artistic. 32 hours. You see, I could say many things about that, but I'm going to explain. This piece was 32 hours, 2 16 sittings with two artists. Wow. Honestly, I mean, I hope you've got life insurance and health insurance. Take yourself to a spa, babe. Have a break, but beautiful piece. Step into the light, Caroline. Step into the light. If you're old, you'll get that joke. If you're not, it's funny, just make a laughing noise anyway. Well done, that piece is gorgeous, Louise. Right, next up, I'm gonna read the sheet first. 29, when the judge is ready. Oh, well, are you wearing sliders, Alfie? Not on my stage, you're not. I'm joking. But the thing I have about sliders, how can you run away from people in there? Try to test it out now. I'll give you a hint. Actually, I'm too fat to run, sweetheart, so I'll get you anyway. Okay, if you want to come onto the stage for me, Alfie, this piece I know Leicester quite well. I spent many time there for university and in the prison. It wasn't for me again. I never get caught. This is the thing. I always set someone else up. I just go and visit them. And also, anyone brave enough to wear sliders to a tattoo convention? I know it's for comfort, but I don't get it when I see people out in the rain in them. Your feet get wet. It's a definite fashion statement that they are. I can appreciate the sliders.
You have the sliders?
Yeah, and the racer vest top. It's a mood, you know. Very on par with the young folk now. Thank you so much there, Elfie. Look at that, I can see the end. The end is nigh. I just meant of a contestant bit, not like an apocalypse, because that's a bit depressing. When the weather's screaming apocalypse, I'm just waiting for the zombies, because then I can blend in. I was excited you turned up as well. Yay, were me! Next up, thank you, Roger. James Tarpenton, is that correct? Good, because I'm not saying it again. He's done Tattoo Mart at Studio 42 in Kent. Again, another place that's famous for some fucking thing. That's literally all I've got for Kent. If anyone knows any interesting facts for Kent, good for you. I'm still impressed that I haven't really murdered anyone's name yet. Or they just haven't told me because I'm scary as chuff. Fudge. Why do people bring more children to the front? I'm just like, they make me nervous. No, it's all right, because normally they get too close, I kick them. But apparently that's not good adulting. I wouldn't kick you, my love, I wouldn't kick you. You're too, I like your dress. Just boys. It's boys over 18. I just kick them. You'll learn, honestly, you'll learn. Hopefully in a nice way, you won't be damaged like me, but you know, I'm sure Mum will help you with that one. Thank you so much. Next up, I'm gonna fold it over. The excitement. Honestly, another danger show, seeing if I get a paper cut. I can't even open an envelope without slitting my finger, it's ridiculous. I need insurance just for breathing. Are we the judges? God, you guys are working hard. I can just swear. I mean, if I had grapes, I would feed them to you. Or would I peel them for you? Anything. And I mean that in the creepiest Buffalo Bill way. So if you want a new skin suit, I'm good. I can sort you out. Right. Woody's going, shut up, Smush. I can hear your thoughts from here, mate. Hold on, let me... Yep, we're going to go for the next contestant. Number 32, is that correct? 31's empty. So, number 31. Okay, where do you want to come on stage and I'll get the details from you, my lovely? It's a big old gap.
All right, we're ad lib.
Yeah, okay. Now he wants me to continue talking. Honestly, it's such a tease. I don't know whether I'm coming or going. Well, definitely going. So again, I have no details. So this is someone who has been tattooed and is part of the competition. Thank you. I can't see you for this hair, honestly. It's literally so big. It gives me a bit of a Dolly Parton feel, but then I realise, no, because she's actually worth a lot of money, not 16 quid from Brixton Market. Again, someone who's been tattooed somewhere by someone else. Tegan. Hi, Tegan. Oh, been tattooed by CB. Studio 42. In Kent, the place I don't know anything interesting about, but apparently, thank you, Woody, the Garden of England. Woo! Thank you for giving us the information. Can I get you? I know I'm scary, but... just come this way, she just wants to get a photo. So, Kent is called the Garden of England.
Thank you, Roger.
Thank you, Roger. What number are we?
32 Lewis.
32 Lewis.
Come on, Lewis.
Come on, Lewis. Come on, then. Lewis is up for this, you can tell. Been tattooed by Molly Lou from Electric Snake Tattoo in Essex. And again, this is looking like a pretty fresh piece, as most tattoos are when they're done at a convention. I'm a genius. I'm also very observational and slow. See this gentleman dressed appropriately with shorts? Think you could reveal a little bit, but not give it all away. I like that. It's a tease. It's a, oh, hello, you know, bit of a shoulder, bit of a thigh. If you want to just stand there so the lovely photo lady can take a photo. Thank you so much. A beautiful piece, my darling. Thank you so much. I love how we've just given up on clapping for anyone now. We'll do a big round of applause at the end, I promise. I love this. 34, Jamesy Gibson. Come on up, my lovely. I believe I'm going to double check. Tattooed by Rachel Satwell at Home Rachel Tattoo from Bournemouth. Again, Bournemouth. All I know about is full of old people. That's where I go to date now. I'm living my life as Anna Nicole Smith did. Gonna find a very rich old man, kill him off, and then try not to die of an overdose. Unless it's donuts. If it's donuts, I'm gone. Have you ever had a donut with apple in it? Like apple jam? I lost my shit. I was like, what is this? I loved it. It's the best relationship I ever had was with a donut. I totally understand why Homer dreams of them. Apart from the hole, the one with the hole in it, I feel cheated. Thank you so much. I know I'm scary up here, Josie. You're doing a cracking job, sweetheart. Thank you very much. Okay. Woody sat there holding his head, and I don't know if it's because my commentating has gotten so bad he's regretting booking me, or if he's just questioning life in general. You know, the thinking man, what was he thinking about? Well, age-old question. What do most men think about? Again, wouldn't like to go too far out of things. I mean, I could ask, but there are children, so I can look at people and kind of imagine what they're thinking about. We'll say that for another time, safe by Roger. Number 35, okay, is it David Rossi? Hi there, David. If you want to come over, please. I see you've been tattooed by Mickey C at Cloak & Dagger, London. Oh, it's right on the knee. And they're like, can you put your leg up? This is some torture now. Again, bending knees is always a struggle when you get to my age, as are lunges. I did too, that's personal best. I'm finding the colour very vibrant, and it's just quite strange just seeing skin up close and not touching it or licking it. But again, there are rules of convention. I think they're overrated. Can we just get a picture, please, my love? That's gorgeous. And your tattoo's alright as well. Honestly, I'm turning, as the night goes on, I'm becoming more and more like Sid James. Obviously, I already look like him. The beard is natural. I don't know how I'm making myself laugh, and you're all just there going, who is this? I'll let you into a secret. I am here on day release. Woody's been doing some care in the community and helped get me out, so I appreciate that a lot. Okay, I mean, Roger with a thumb says we've got to number 36. Is that Catalin? Hi, my love. If you'd like to come up onto the stage, show us what you've got and your tattoo. This is a piece. I've got two names here. We've got Ian Botez and Alex Elkaz from Famous Tattoos and Atelier in UK and Romania. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Again, another 2 days, two artists. Honestly, you all are showing me up. I cry after 30 minutes. And that's just because someone's touching me. I've been that lonely. Anyway, enough of me. Again, on the chest. Does that bit hurt on a man? Does that bit hurt? Good. Sorry. I meant that in the nicest way. Where my inside voice just becomes loud because of the microphone. I'm not allowed to use normally. I just have to shout to offend people. It is beautiful. Honestly, I'm going to haunt your nightmares tonight. Lucky bugger. Yeah, you look genuinely scared. I know I'm doing my job right on there. I can smell fear in the air. Right. Roger? 38. I'm not deaf. They're mouthing out of me. Okay. 38. Number 38, get ready. Oh. Oh, oh. Also, I just wanted to see your lunch, sweetheart. Thank you for that. It's a pleasure. This is Lewis at Nip and Thomas Martinez, Sanctum Tattoo, Hertfordshire, which is, again, is this all over the weekend by two artists? I mean, one getting that close to another tattoo artist without fighting, I'm impressed. Unless there's like a jelly ring, then we're good to go, but maybe not. Is that the name of your new band, Woody? Soaring Stiff? Yeah! Hashtag Soaring Stiff. That's what we want to hear. Social media, tag Woody in it. Only partial buttock, but again, it's for art's sake, so it's allowed. Don't worry, we're getting closer and closer to the last couple of contestants. Aren't we, Roger? Roger's excited to just get away from me. And now I know his name. Where do you live, Roger? You're not telling me, are you? God damn it! I'll find out, I'm really good. It's rather lovely. Yeah, well done. Congratulations for having a leg. Oh, the bell. Well, I mean, the leg tap. Anyway, thank you so much. How are we doing? 39. Number 39. I'm just going to give him a minute. Are you ready? Like Chris Akabusi. Is he the one who does a wooga? I was saying a wooga the other day and I don't know where it's come from. A wooga. Oh, showing my age. Got the thumb up. If we can get you up, this is number 39. Ed Stanger. Dean Gunther's tattooed you at DG Tattoo Art. In Greater Manchester, not just Manchester, Greater Manchester. I like that. Do you think Mancunians just went, do you know what? I want to be better than everyone else, we are greater. Which is understandable, I like Manchester. So I'm just listening in. It's been done over the weekend, 9 hours yesterday, and finished off in about a 4.5 hour sitting today. So again, lower leg, sore and stiff. Ooh, I like it. I like it a lot. I mean, it's shining and glistening from here. Is that sweat? I know it's being near me. I just make that happen with some people. That's a beautiful piece, my lovely. If we could just wait here and get a... Oh, she don't want your picture now. Rude much. I do, sweetheart. I always want pictures. And if we're ready, last but no means least, is it Sunita? If you'd like to come to the stage, my darling. Thank you so much. This is a piece by Tom Maggett at Minor Head Tattoo, based in Birmingham. Oh, you've done this before, haven't you? You're like, got my wings, baby. It's beautiful. Thank you so much for showing it to us as well. We appreciate it, honestly. So again, looking at this piece, it looks like it's been worked on for many hours. You're like, yes. Do you even know how many hours in total? and fuck tongue. Which is, again, a real measure in time and things, I tell you. Wonderful. Did you want a photo of this? Try and get a video. If that's all right with you, we'll get a video of your back when the judges are done. Lovely. Thank you so much. Again, that's a stunning piece. And obviously, see, we're appreciative. Thank you so much. Everyone's still awake, just about. Brilliant. Thank you so much, my darling. And that, I believe, Roger, is all the contestants. Honestly, I'm happy. His wig's heavy. So what the judges are now, they're going to deliberate. And I'm going to do some shout-outs. Basically, I've been here all weekend. You might have noticed me or heard me. Most people do because I'm loud. But it's been such a fantastic atmosphere. And the thing I love about tattoo conventions is the sense of community. Like, I've been smiled at by people and I've not felt weirded out. Like, when men in London are walking down the road smiling, it's creepy as hell. But here it's been really lovely. It's been a pleasure to meet many of you and scare a few of you and give you trauma. I had this when I was a youth, so it's my gift to you. Amazing. And I don't think I swore that much.
34 times.
34? Okay, Dad's going to give you a pound for everyone, so that's 34. We good? Yes.
Round it up, make it 35.
All right, then 50 quid. 70? Okay, 70 pounds we've done. Thanks, Dad.
20.
I'll take the other 30. I like this, 70, 30 is good. And we'll make some lollipops, sweetheart. I might steal your trainers. What size shoe are you?
I don't know.
You don't know? I think they're too small for me, but I might still steal them. Because they're shiny. My inner magpie's gone crazy this weekend. I tried to pick something up off of someone's table and realised it was their phone. I wasn't stealing it. It was shiny. Pretty. Ah. Right. They've got all thinking faces on.